And it's amazing how everybody's position on WikiLeaks absolutely reversed over the past 6 years, 7 years, 9 years. Originally, it was the right looking at WikiLeaks as an evil Russian front organization dedicated to spilling American military secrets and putting American lives in danger. That assessment, I think, was correct. And then after WikiLeaks started dumping out DNC material, started dumping out John Podesta email, then you heard people on the right, some people, we won't name names, suggesting that WikiLeaks was suddenly good. That WikiLeaks was suddenly somebody, people who were worth listening to. They had valuable information to provide. Well, a couple things can be true at once. One, some of the information that you provide in document dumps is probably valuable information. Two, you can also be a tool of the Russians and one of the world's worst humans, and that apparently is Julian Assange. The arrest came 24 hours after WikiLeaks accused Ecuador of an extensive spying operation, adding that it assumed intel had been handed over to the administration of Donald Trump. So Ecuador, Assange basically bit the hand that fed him, and Ecuador was like, well, guess what? You have diplomatic immunity because you're in our embassy? Well, here's what we can do. And they just removed his diplomatic immunity. President Moreno accused Assange of violating the terms of his asylum by interfering in internal affairs of other states, as well as blocking security cameras and mistreating guards. The actual indictment that came down from the DOJ alleges that in March of 2010, Assange engaged in a conspiracy with Chelsea Manning, a former intelligence analyst in the U.S. Army, to assist Manning in cracking a password stored on U.S. Department of Defense computers connected to the Secret Internet Protocol Network, a U.S. government network used for classified documents and communications. Apparently, Manning, who had access to the computers in connection with her duties as an intelligence analyst, Manning was a man at the time. They should really say his duties as an intelligence analyst, since we are speaking historically, and if we are speaking biologically, is still a man. In any case, Manning was using the computers to download classified records to transmit to WikiLeaks. Cracking the password would have allowed Manning to log onto the computers under a username that did not belong to her, says the DOJ. Such a deceptive measure would have made it more difficult for investigators to determine the source of the illegal disclosures. That is not a journalistic tactic. That is a hacking tactic. A journalistic tactic is somebody comes to you with material and then you print it. A hacking tactic is somebody says, if you help me hack the U.S. Department of Defense, then you can have the resulting material. That's a crime. During the conspiracy, Manning and Assange engaged in real-time discussions regarding Manning's transmission of classified records to Assange. The discussions also reflect Assange actively encouraging Manning to provide more information. During an exchange, Manning told Assange that, quote, after this upload, that's all I really have left, to which Assange replied, curious eyes never run dry in my experience. Assange is now being charged with conspiracy to commit computer intrusion. He's presumed innocent unless and until proven guilty beyond a reasonable doubt, says the DOJ. If convicted, he faces a max of 5 years in prison. But Assange, in fact, was doing tremendous damage to innocent people by releasing all of these documents. He was allowing persecution of people who were coordinating with the United States government to fight the Taliban in Afghanistan. That's some pretty bad stuff. I mean, even The Nation came out against him in 2016, talking about how he was undermining dissenters in foreign countries. It's pretty terrible. It's pretty terrible stuff. Julian Assange and WikiLeaks have engaged in really, really bad activity. So it is a good thing for the world that Assange was arrested today. It's a good thing. Boston University, there's a fellow named Paul Hare who teaches over at Boston University. He's Britain's former ambassador to Cuba. He says, when Edward Snowden thinks you have a big mouth, you may have a problem. Former NSA whistleblower Snowden has criticized WikiLeaks for failing to redact sensitive information, even in the hacked DNC emails, allowing credit card and social security numbers of party donors and guests to tumble into public view. And this has been going on for years. So all the people who are out there today defending Julian Assange, who acted as essentially a front for the Russian government, again, if you were wildly inconsistent on this issue, I think that you have some looking in the mirror to be done.